Hi, welcome to Why and What session of RMIS Academy. This is Rajesh, Faculty of Current Affairs. In this session, we are going to deal with One Health concept. What is One Health concept? One Health is a collaborative, multisectoral, and transdisciplinary approach working at various levels like local, regional, national, and global level with the aim of achieving optimal health outcome. Recognizing the interconnectedness between humans, animals, plants, and their shared environment. So this approach recognizes the health of people is closely connected to the health of animals and shared environment. Basically, this concept is not new. This concept again resurfaces in recent times because many factors have changed interactions between people, animal, plants, and our environment. For example, human population are growing and expanding into new geographical areas. As a result, more people live in close contact with wild and domestic animals, both for livestock and for pet animals. The usage is multiple, like travel, sport, education, food, fiber, companionship. Hence, this close contact with animals and their environment provide more opportunity for diseases to pass between animals and peoples. The earth has experienced changes in climate, and the land use pattern also changes, like deforestation, intensive farming. These all also provide new opportunities for diseases to pass on from animals to humans. Moreover, the movement of people, animal, and animal product has increased the international trade. Hence, this is also a different type, a way where diseases can pass on from animals to humans. As I already mentioned, this One Health concept is not a new one, it is a very old one. In 400 BC, it was Hippocrates. The present doctors used to take oath on his writings. Hippocrates clearly mentioned that there should be a balance between humans and their immediate environment. According to him, all the diseases are the results of imbalance between humans and environment. So he recognized the health of humans is interconnected with the immediate environment. So he spoke about the One Health concept. As I already mentioned, it is not a new one, it is a very old concept, in fact. But why this particular concept is resurfacing again? What is the need of One Health? It should be noted that 60% of existing human infection are zoonotic in nature. Zoonotic diseases are those diseases transmitted from animals to humans. And you can see in the picture that 75% of emerging infectious diseases have originated in animals or animal product. Moreover, of the 5 new human diseases appearing every year, 3 is originating in animals, again zoonotic. 80% of biological agents with potential bioterrorist use are genetic pathogens only. Moreover, it is estimated that zoonotic disease account for nearly 2 million deaths and 2 billion cases per year. Calculate how much the healthcare sector to work towards it. And moreover, 1/5 of premature death in poor countries are attributed to disease transmission from animals to humans. Again, zoonotic disease. So one can understand that the present problem is huge. The transmission of disease from animal to human are, becoming a huge pandemics or epidemics or problem to the whole world. Hence, it is important to follow One Health concept. With respect to India, yes, India is also having One Health concept. Recently, there was a conference that happens in New Delhi by 2019 February, which also speaks about the One Health concept. See, India is among the top geographical hotspots where zoonotic diseases are a major public health issue, causing more mortality and morbidity. Hence, it is important to implement this One Health concept in India also. For example, Brussels, which emerged in Haryana to Goa, anthrax as an occupational zoonotic disease, and bovine tuberculosis is also a problem in India. See, all come together to push Indian healthcare sector to move from different concept to One Health concept. And moreover, if one is not concentrating on this One Health concept, the results are antimicrobial resistance. That's one of the major problem. See, actually, there are certain common issues with respect to One Health concept. The One Health issues include zoonotic diseases, antimicrobial resistance, food security, vector-borne diseases, food safety-related matters, environmental contaminations, and other health all come together to have a better environment. So, if you want to choose One Health in your nation, you need to include almost all the ministries which is working for the overall importance of humans, animals, plants and climate, etc. With this particular picture, you can very well understand the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welcome, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, with respect to Ministry of Science and Technology, all come together to do a concept called One Health concept. See, what is need of the hour? The need of the hour is strengthening veterinary institutions. See, by strengthening veterinary institutions, the human medicine and veterinary medicine will come together, thus achieving the One Health concept. And moreover, the most effective and economical approach is to control zoonotic pathogens at their animal sources. So treat the animal very properly. If you are maintaining the health of animal very properly, then no problem, the One Health concept is completely maintained. It also speaks about greater investment in animal health infrastructure, because we have good health infrastructure for humans, but not good health infrastructure for animals. It is important to invest over there also. Moreover, early detection at animal sources can prevent disease transmission to humans and introduce of new pathogens into the food chain. So these are the things what we can do in a recent times. So this One Health concept is very important and need to take forward for the better health of not only humans, but also animals, plants and their immediate environment. Thus, it can reduce the incidence of zoonotic diseases, not only in India, but all the whole world. Thank you for listening, RMIS Academy's Why and What session. Thank you.